Jeffrey Toobin is back after disappearing from public view. Finally, he should have the first time. Disappearing from public view. He is back after being caught masturbating on a work Zoom call. And that obviously has to be addressed as he returns to CNN. So he and Alisyn Camerota had a talk about it. And boy, do I have some thoughts about this. So here's the introduction to that admittedly incredibly awkward conversation.
I feel like we should address what's happened in the months since we've seen you, since some of our viewers may not know what has happened. So I guess I'll recap. I'll do the honors.
Help yourself.
Okay. In October, you were on a Zoom call with your colleagues from the New Yorker magazine. Everyone took a break for several minutes, during which time you were caught masturbating on camera. You were subsequently fired from that job after 27 years of working there. And you since then have been on leave from CNN. Do I have all that right?
You got it all right, sad to say.
I'm getting mild Scott's Tots vibes here. So Bridget, they have to talk about it. They can't just be like, so what'd you think about Jill Biden's jacket? Well, I mean, not jacket. I'm not saying jacket. I'm saying her coat. What did you think about that? They have to address it. What did you think?
I mean, that was probably one of the most awkward few minutes of television I've ever watched. I think you're right. I mean, it would probably be even worse if they didn't address it. But I don't know that I've ever had this kind of public secondhand embarrassment before. It was the cringiest thing.
Yeah. It was, and there's get ready, hold on to your butts. There's several more videos coming. That was just the intro. And by the way, I'm not necessarily, I can't predict what the audience expects, but I'm not necessarily going to come out on this exactly as they might expect. That said, right off the bat, I wouldn't have had her have to recap it. That doesn't seem quite, maybe that's the most minor part of the story, but make him say what he did. Why does Alisyn Camerota have to say it and then have him sort of smiling say, you got me? I don't like that.
Good point that it seems a little unfair to make the woman have to go through the incredibly painfully awkward process of breaking this down. He doesn't even really have to say it. He just has to sort of agree that it happened. I didn't even think about that, but I think you're exactly right.
Yeah, so let's dive into the substance of this. Here's the next bit of their talk.
Okay. To quote Jay Leno, what the hell were you thinking?
Well, obviously, I wasn't thinking very well or very much. And it was something that was inexplicable to me. I think one point, I wouldn't exactly say in my defense, because nothing is really in my defense. I didn't think I was on the call. I didn't think other people could see me.
You so, thought that you had turned off your camera?
Correct. I thought that I had turned off the Zoom call. Now, that's not a defense. This was deeply moronic and indefensible. But I mean, that is part of the story.
Second most minor part of this, Bridget, he's doing a lot of like this. Don't just keep your hands to yourself, visible, but to yourself. Okay, so Bridget, did you doubt, did anyone doubt that he thought that he couldn't be seen?
I have a hard time believing it. I mean,
believing what?
Believing that he truly thought that he couldn't be seen. I mean, I don't know. All I'll say is, you know, we've all been using Zoom since the pandemic. I think at this point, you know that when you go into a Zoom, your camera's visible. You know, this is what he says, this is what he's saying. But I also think like, I really want to push back on the way that he's framed it, that like, oh, it was just a moronic thing. You know, this is a pretty serious workplace misconduct thing. Like, it wasn't just a mistake, a moronic mistake. A moronic mistake is when you reply all on a group email. I really am uncomfortable with the way that he's framing this as a kind of a silly whoops moment, because it's pretty serious.
Sure. So I think we part agree and part disagree, but let's dive into it and let's see. I agree with you that to the extent that he is framing it as not being serious, he's both, I think, objectively wrong, and also it's not up to him. But I do think he needs to make clear, if it wasn't intentional, then that's an important part of the story that he needs to make sure we focus on. And I'm trying to figure out if we disagree on this. I just assume obviously it's a mistake, because the alternative is he was on a work call with a bunch of journalists and purposefully masturbated where they could see. That seems like the quickest way to, that's like a George Costanza, I want you to fire me sort of situation. Like he's done then. I just assume it can't possibly have been on purpose. There have been other people, there have been Twitch streamers that have been caught masturbating or having sex because they forgot that their, you know, camera was on or whatever. I have a friend, actually, a journalist, who didn't know that her partner was on a work call, so she walked naked through the background of a shot. Like, obviously accidental things happen. That's not to say that it's not serious, but I assume it had to have been accidental.
Yeah, I mean, if it wasn't accidental, then we're talking about something like a completely.
Then it's insane,
right?
Like, yeah. if it wasn't accidental, it's Louis CK at that point. Like, yeah. that's crazy.
I hate to say that, like, I hope it was accidental, but yeah, if it was purposeful, then that's a whole different thing. And, you know, I know that mistakes happen. Certainly, I have been on Zoom where, you know, things happen where you wish it hadn't, or you're like, oh, that was dumb. But I guess I feel like even if his camera was off, even if things had went the way that he was thinking they were gonna go, it's still really unacceptable.
Yes. Yeah. No, I think we can all agree on that. And even then, you know, there are concerns of, like, potentially about, well, did he think that his camera was off, but he was still watching their cameras? Cause then that's kind of uncomfortable in its own way. Yeah. But I think that's a core part. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.